Hello my dear students, I am Deepak Vanjani. Today we will study about electric dipole. What is electric dipole? A system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a finite distance is called electric dipole. System of two equal and opposite charges. Equal in the sense they should have equal magnitude. So I am considering here minus Q charge and plus Q charge. Their magnitudes are same. But here both the charges are having opposite polarity. A system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a finite distance. They are separated by some finite distance, that is 2a. So this system is called electric dipole. Once again I am repeating the definition. A system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a finite distance is called an electric dipole. So here minus Q and plus Q charge are separated by 2a distance. Here strength of this dipole is measured by one physical quantity called electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment is denoted by small p. How can we define electric dipole moment? Electric dipole moment is the product of magnitude of either charge of dipole into separation between them. Once again, electric dipole moment is the product of magnitude of either charge of dipole and separation between them. So P is equal to magnitude of either charge Q into separation between them, that is 2A. So P is equal to 2A into Q. Direction of electric dipole moment is always from minus Q to plus Q. That I have shown by arrow, from minus Q to plus Q. Unit of electric dipole moment is coulomb meter. Unit of charge, that is coulomb. Unit of distance, that is meter. So unit of dipole moment, coulomb meter. Here C you have to write in capital. If you will write it in small, then it will be considered as centimeter. But unit of electric dipole moment is coulomb meter. So you have to write capital C. If we consider total charge, then total charge of electric dipole is nothing but minus Q plus Q, that will be zero. It means net charge of the system is zero. So electric field of the dipole will be zero or not? No. Electric field of dipole surrounding to the dipole will never be zero. If you consider any point surrounding to the dipole, then there won't be any point where electric field is zero. At each and every point surrounding to the dipole, you will get some electric field. Why? Because here these two charges are separated by some finite distance. They are separated. They are not at same point. Therefore, you will get some electric field surrounding to the dipole. Important theory of this chapter. Electric field at a point on the axis of a dipole. Now we have to find electric field at a point on the axis of dipole. So first of all, we have to draw one axis passing through the dipole. This is the axis which is passing through the dipole. This point is the center of dipole. From the center of dipole, if you find the distance of plus Q, then that will be A. And if you find the distance of minus Q from the center of dipole, that will be A. So total separation is 2A. I am considering one point near to plus Q, which is at a distance R from the center of dipole, that is point P. At point P, we have to find electric field due to dipole. So here we will have electric field due to this plus Q point charge and electric field due to minus Q point charge. Electric field due to plus Q point charge will be in which direction? Away from the charge. So here direction of electric field due to positive charge is towards right. And electric field due to negative charge is always towards negative charge. So here the direction of electric field is towards negative charge. So direction of electric field due to negative charge is towards left, towards negative charge minus Q. Here electric field due to positive charge will be more and electric field due to negative charge will be less. Why? Because separation, that is the distance of point P from plus Q charge, is less एंड डिस्टेंस ऑफ पॉइंट पी फ्रॉम माइनस क्यू चार्ज इज मोर एज डिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड डिक्रीजेज देयरफॉर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू प्लस क्यू चार्ज विल बी मोर इफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू प्लस क्यू चार्ज इज मोर देन नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड शुड बी towards bigger electric field that is electric field due to positive charge so net electric field will be towards right let the point p be at a distance r from the center of the dipole on the side of the charge q electric field at point p due to plus q charge we have to find first we will find electric field due to plus q charge then we will find electric field due to minus q charge First we will find electric field due to plus q charge then we will find electric field due to minus q charge and then we will find net electric field is the vector sum of electric field due to plus q charge and electric field due to minus q charge according to superposition principle okay first electric field at point p due to plus q charge plus q that is point charge and we know the formula of electric field due to point charge Electric field due to point charge is nothing but 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into q upon r square. So, E plus q vector is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught charge, that is q, upon distance between point P and plus q, that is distance of point P from the center of dipole is r, distance of plus q from the center of dipole is a, So, distance between plus q and p that is r minus a. So, we can write electric field due to positive charge is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r minus a whole square into unit vector. Unit vector we have to write for direction. Direction of electric field due to positive charge is from minus q to plus q. It means that is in the direction of dipole moment. So here I am taking p cap from minus q to plus q. So e plus q is from minus q to plus q. So here we have to write unit vector p cap. We know that here we have taken vector electric field. Therefore vector is nothing but magnitude into unit vector. So magnitude 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into q upon r minus a whole square into unit vector that is p cap. Same way we have to find electric field at point P due to minus Q charge, negative charge. Electric field due to negative charge is nothing but magnitude into unit vector. First magnitude of electric field due to minus Q charge 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into magnitude of minus Q that is Q upon distance of minus Q from point P. Distance between negative charge and point P that is R plus A. So here we have to write E minus Q vector is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q upon R plus A whole square into unit vector. Direction of electric field due to negative charge is in the direction opposite to P cap. So we have to take unit vector minus P cap. Now net electric field, total field at point P is vector sum of electric field due to positive charge and electric field due to negative charge. So E vector is equal to E vector plus Q plus E vector minus Q is equal to from these two equations what can we take common 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught and P cap. So if we take and Q also we can take out. So Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught into P cap. So what is left inside the bracket 1 upon R minus A whole square minus 1 upon r plus a whole square. If we take LCM, then net electric field is equal to q upon 4 pi epsilon naught into r plus a whole square minus r minus a whole square into LCM r minus a square into r plus a square into p cap as it is. Okay. If you open this bracket, then a plus b whole square will give you a square plus 2ab plus b square. So r square plus 2ar plus a square. Negative sign minus square of first term r square. 2ar that will be negative minus minus plus plus 2ar plus a square into negative. That will give you minus a square upon a minus b into a plus b that is a square minus b square. And here square is available. So we can write r minus a into r plus a, that is r square minus a square, and square of whole bracket. So r square minus a square whole square into p cap. Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught as it is. R square minus r square will get cancelled. A square minus a square will get cancelled. So what will remain? 2ar plus 2ar, that is 4ar upon r square minus a square whole square into p cap as it is. Okay. This is the general formula of electric field on any point. This is the general formula of electric field at any point on the axis of dipole. If we consider a special case for r much greater than a, then electric field for r much greater than a is given by q upon 4 pi epsilon naught as it is, 4ar as it is, 4ar as it is. But here r is much greater than a. So here if r is much greater than a, then we can neglect a in comparison to r. So r square minus a square will give you only r square. So here if r square will remain, then square of r square will give you r raised to 4 into p cap. E vector is equal to q upon 4 pi epsilon naught into r. R will get cancelled, therefore 4a upon r cube into p cap. Okay, now we know that this 4 can be written as 2 into 2. So 4a cube can be written as 2 into 2a cube. But 2a cube is nothing but p, so 2p. So instead of 4a cube, we can write 2p. Unit vector 2a cube into p cap. That is p cap is from minus q to plus q. That is giving us the direction of dipole moment. This is magnitude into unit vector. That will give you vector quantity. So 2a cube into p cap, that is p vector. So instead of 4a cube, we can write 2p vector upon 4 pi epsilon naught into r cube. Here 2a, that is separation between two charges, that is fixed. Magnitude of either charge, that is fixed. Therefore magnitude of p, that is fixed. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, that is constant. So we can say that electric field is inversely proportional to cube of the distance. If we find the electric field at a far distance on the axis of a dipole, then electric field is inversely proportional to cube of distance. Okay. One more important theory of this chapter: electric field at a point on the equator of a dipole. The concept of dipole is very important for standard 12. What is called equator? The perpendicular bisector to the line joining the two electric charges of the dipole is called the equator of a dipole. Once again, if we draw the perpendicular bisector from the line joining two charges of dipole, minus q and plus q, then that perpendicular bisector is called equator. So this is called equator. Or you can say perpendicular drawn from the center of the axis is called equator. Now we have to consider one point on the equator. Here if we consider dipole, suppose one charge is at this end of the pencil and another charge is at this end of the pencil, then we can have one axis of this dipole, one axis which is passing through this two charges, minus q and plus q, like this. And if we have to find equator, then we have to draw perpendicular from the axis. That perpendicular can be in this direction, that perpendicular can be in this direction, that perpendicular can be in downward direction. So here there can be infinite equator for electric dipole. So here axis we have to consider only one, but if we consider one plane, then in that plane we can have equator in too many directions. So here if we have to consider the number, then we can consider infinite number of equators. And Here they are asking us to find electric field at a point on the equator of dipole. Now we have to find electric field at a point on the equator of dipole. On this equator we have to consider one point. That point I am taking P, which is at a distance r from the center of dipole. Okay, distance between two charges, that is 2a. Distance of plus q from the center of dipole, that is a. Distance of minus q from the center of dipole is a. So if we apply Pythagoras theorem, then here the distance between plus q and p, that is r square plus a square raised to 1/2. Same way, distance between minus q and p, that will be r square plus a square raised to 1/2. If we have to find a net electric field at point P, then first we have to find electric field at point P due to positive charge. Then we have to find electric field at point P due to negative charge. And to find total electric field, we have to take vector sum of electric field due to positive charge and electric field due to negative charge. This way we can find total electric field at a point on the equator of a dipole. The magnitudes of the electric fields due to the charges plus Q and minus Q are given by electric field due to positive charge and electric field due to negative charge at point P. We are finding, that is, E plus Q and E minus Q. We know the formula of electric field due to point charge, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into charge upon square of distance. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into charge, that is plus Q upon square of distance. Distance between point P and plus Q, that is r square plus a square raised to r square plus a square raised to 1/2, and square of that will give us r square plus a square. Same way, magnitude of electric field due to negative charge, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. You don't have to take minus Q because we are taking magnitude. Magnitude of minus Q, that comes out to be plus Q upon distance, that will be again r square plus a square raised to 1/2 square. That will give you r square plus a square. Okay, here we can see magnitude of electric field due to positive charge and magnitude of electric field due to negative charge is same. Therefore, we can take E plus Q is equal to E minus Q is equal to E dash. Okay. Now, once again, we have to refer figure. Electric field due to plus Q charge at point P, if we have to find, then electric field due to positive charge is away from the charge. Therefore, away from the charge. That is in this direction, E plus Q. And electric field due to negative charge is towards the negative charge. So E minus Q will be in this direction. Here, angle. This angle, if we take theta, then angle between net electric field and E plus Q will be theta, because these two are corresponding angles. Here, if we take this angle as theta, then angle between net electric field and E minus Q will be theta, because alternate angles you can see. Okay, so here we have two electric field, electric field due to positive charge and electric field due to negative charge, but they are making some angle. Therefore, we have to resolve it into two components. Component of electric field due to positive charge, if I consider in this direction, then component of electric field opposite to theta, that is sine theta, so E plus Q sine theta. Same way, component of E plus Q adjacent to theta, this will give us E plus Q cos theta. Okay. Same way, we have to find electric component, two components of electric field due to negative charge. Component of E minus Q opposite to theta, that will be in downward direction, that is E minus Q sine theta. Component of E minus Q adjacent to theta, that will be E minus Q cos theta. Adjacent means cos, opposite means sine. Here you can see E plus Q sine theta and E minus Q sine theta both are in opposite direction. E plus Q and E minus Q both are having same value. Therefore, here E plus Q and E minus Q both are having same magnitude but opposite direction. Therefore, they will cancel the effect of each other. E plus Q cos theta and E minus Q cos theta both are in the same direction. Therefore, they will be added up and they will give you the total electric field E. Okay, so net electric field is due to adjacent components of electric field. The components of E plus vector and E minus vector normal to the dipole axis are E plus sine theta and E minus sine theta. These components canceled each other since they are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. The components of E plus vector and E minus vector along the dipole axis are E plus cos theta and minus cos theta respectively. They will be added up since they are in the same direction. The total electric field is opposite to P cap. Here, once again, we have to refer figure. Okay. Here, net electric field is from plus Q to minus Q. And direction of P cap, that is always from minus Q to plus Q. So we can say that net electric field is opposite to P cap. Therefore, total electric field E vector is equal to E plus Q plus E minus Q cos theta. It means that is nothing but E plus Q cos theta plus E minus Q cos theta into unit vector. Unit vector we have to write minus P cap. Negative I have taken common minus E plus Q plus E minus Q cos theta P cap. Minus P cap means net electric field is in the direction opposite to P cap. But E plus Q and E minus Q already we found. E plus Q and E minus Q, that is nothing but E dash. Therefore, instead of E plus Q, I can write E dash. Instead of E minus Q, I can write E dash. So, E dash plus E dash cos theta into P cap. E dash plus E dash, that is 2 E dash cos theta into P cap. 2 as it is, E dash. Already we found the value of E dash. E dash is equal to Q upon R square plus A square. So, E dash is equal to, sorry, here 4 pi epsilon naught also we have to write. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q upon R square plus A square into cos theta into P cap. From figure, now we will find cos theta. From figure, cos theta is equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. Adjacent, that is A. Hypotenuse, that is R square plus A square raised to 1 by 2 for this triangle. P, this center of dipole, and plus Q charge. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side A upon hypotenuse R square plus A square raised to 1 by 2. Therefore, net electric field is minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2 Q upon R square plus A square. R square plus A square. Into A upon R square plus A square raised to 1 by 2. This is the value of cos theta into P cap. 2Q into A can be written as 2AQ. 4 pi epsilon naught as it is. R square plus A square. Here R square plus A square is having power 1. And R square plus A square is having power 1 by 2. If base are same, then we can add the powers. 1 plus 1 by 2, that will give you 3 by 2. So minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2A into Q upon R square plus A square raised to 3 by 2 into P cap. 2A into Q into P cap, that is nothing but P vector, electric dipole moment. So net electric field E vector is equal to minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into P vector upon R square plus A square raised to 3 by 2. This is the general formula of electric field at any point on the equator of dipole. If R is much greater than A, then if we take special case, if point of consideration is very far away from the dipole, then E vector is equal to minus 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught P vector upon R cube. Because value of A is negligible, so we can neglect A. If you neglect A, then R square into 3 by 2, R square raised to 3 by 2, 2, 2 will get cancelled, so we will get R cube. Here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, that is constant. P, electric dipole moment, that is constant. So we can say that electric field is inversely proportional to Q of distance when point of consideration is very far away from the dipole. So if we consider electric field due to dipole at any point on the axis of dipole or at any point on the equator of dipole, when this point of consideration are very far away from the dipole, then electric field of dipole at a large distance falls off not as 1 upon R square but as 1 upon R cube. For electric field due to point charge, electric field is inversely proportional to square of distance. If we consider point of consideration to be far away from dipole, then electric field is inversely proportional to cube of distance. So we can say that इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड गिव्स द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ सोर्स. इफ सोर्स इज पॉइंट चार्ज देन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू क्यू इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू स्क्वायर ऑफ द डिस्टेंस. इफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इन्वर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू क्यूब ऑफ डिस्टेंस देन वी कैन से दैट सोर्स इज डायपोल. नाउ व्हाट इज पॉइंट डायपोल. पॉइंट डायपोल फॉर दैट इफ सेपरेशन बिटवीन टू चार्जेस इज वेरी स्मॉल इट मीन्स टू ए टेंस टू जीरो एंड मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ चार्ज इज वेरी लार्ज देन वी कैन से दैट दैट डायपोल इज पॉइंट डायपोल. दैट डायपोल कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज पॉइंट डायपोल. एंड फॉर पॉइंट डायपोल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विच वी गोट एट फार डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द डायपोल फॉर एक्सिस एंड इक्वेटर दैट इज ट्रू फॉर पॉइंट डायपोल एट एनी डिस्टेंस आर. फॉर वेरी फार एंड इक्विडिस्टेंस पॉइंट्स ऑन एक्सिस एंड इक्वेटर ऑफ डायपोल इफ पॉइंट ऑफ कंसिडरेशन ऑन इक्वेटर एंड एक्सिस आर एट द सेम डिस्टेंस बट दे आर वेरी फार अवे फ्रॉम द डायपोल देन इक्वेशन मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑन द एक्सिस ऑफ डायपोल इज गिवन बाय द इक्वेशन 1/4πε0 × 2π/r³ ऑलरेडी वी हैव ऑब्टेन एंड इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑन द इक्वेटर ऑफ डायपोल राइट नाउ वी हैव ऑब्टेन. मैग्नीट्यूड इफ यू फाइंड देन वी डोंट हैव टू कंसिडर नेगेटिव साइन. नेगेटिव साइन व्हाट डज नेगेटिव साइन इंडिकेट. नेगेटिव साइन इंडिकेट टोटल इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑपोजिट टू इलेक्ट्रिक डायपोल मोमेंट. सो मैग्नीट्यूड विल रिमेन 1/4πε0 p/r³. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑन द इक्वेटर 1/4πε0 × p/r³. इंस्टेड ऑफ 1/4πε0 p/r³ वी कैन राइट ई इक्वेटर. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ऑन द एक्सिस ऑफ डायपोल इज twice the electric field on the equator when we consider point very far away from the dipole and if they are at equidistance it means distance is same that is r. therefore we can say electric field on the axis is twice the electric field on the equator. try to solve these sums for practice which are based on electric dipole. total 4 sums I have given, first, second, third and fourth. Third, you have to solve example 1.10 of NCERT book and fourth, that is exercise numerical 1.9 of NCERT book. Thank you.